Annenberg TV News.
Participants of the drill only pretended to be injured victims in the simulated 7.8 magnitude earthquake. Today's much-anticipated Southern California ShakeOut helped people prepare just in case the big one really hits. Good evening, I'm Matt Schrader.
And I'm Renault House. With more than 5 million participants, it was the largest earthquake drill in history. Here on campus, thousands of people took part in today's drill. ATVN's Ned Dannenberg has more on a simulation and how organizers went all out to make the disaster seem real.
It was an early morning for the hundreds of volunteers taking part in the Great ShakeOut on campus.
You're going to be awake and alert.
75 people played the part of victims injured during the 7.8 magnitude quake. There were plenty of fake injuries and lots of blood.
It's scary so much, but I've got a high tolerance.
The victims then moved into position and waited for rescue teams to arrive.
What we're doing here is having three teams going to different buildings searching for victims. You just kind of go with it, and as things unfold, you deal with the situation.
But the drill wasn't just for the first responder. At 10 a.m., students across campus were told to practice duck, cover, and hold.
Good morning, Steve. Well, we're outside the Annenberg School of Communications where they are simulating an earthquake, obviously. They are getting ready and doing, participating in the Great Southern California ShakeOut. You can see they are going to be setting up triage units here and also just really attending to the injured.
Hey, there's been a 7.8 earthquake, it feels like. We're here at the university. We're going to, the EOC has let me know that there's a lot of injured people here on campus, and they are currently assessing the situation.
If you can hear my voice, that's the building.
Oh,
no,
we've got to stabilize this. This is the injured shoulder. You want to do that?
It was real. You went in there building smoke, people laying around. You know it's a drill, but when we started actually doing the drill, then it became real.
You need to go back in.
All right. Yeah,
four
media is
taken out already.
Take your time. All right. Take a breath. Relax. All right. You guys are doing a great job. We've all received excellent training from all the different groups on campus. I think we're very well prepared, and hopefully we don't have to put it to use. But I think the campus is better prepared because of a day like today.
A triage, a multi-casualty incident area has been set up here on the campus in the track field, actually, and you can see the tarps. The green, yellow, and red. And we see these types of tarps across Southern California during major breaking news situations where there's been multiple injuries. The red, the most critically injured. The yellow means moderate injuries. And green, minor injuries. And they're treating this like it's for real. And they're taking people off out of buildings. They're search and rescue officials on campus here. And they're literally taking those people from buildings that would have been damaged by this 7.8 magnitude earthquake on the southern end of the San Andreas Fault. There's some of them now, and they will be lining these injured people up on the appropriate tarp according to their injuries. So they're acting like this just occurred. They're searching for these individuals that may be stuck under rubble. Very tall buildings here in USC, some of them quite old. This is all a drill, everybody, but a good drill indeed. And this is the type of situation we would be seeing all over Southern California in the event of that size earthquake hitting the East Coachella Valley.
I'll come back. I don't understand why everybody's holding me. Why are you holding me? Don't hold me. I am fine. Let me go get my kid.
We have about a third of our folks are severely injured, life-threatening, and then the other folks have minor injuries, all of which require splinting or bandaging type of first aid.